Hey, welcome back. It's time for another Dueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. I'll be joined by Mike Girvin from Excel is Fun. This is our episode 150, VLOOKUP greater than 100. That's actually what I want to do, but it's not going to work. You know, Mike said, hey, there are a lot of solutions to this, and this is funny. I've come up with 39 solutions to it, and the first 38 didn't work. It's very, very frustrating. And from YouTube, wants to look through column B, find the first value that is greater than some arbitrary number, let's say 100, and then return the corresponding cell from column A. Wow, I'm not feeling very smart today. So here's what I came up with. I'm going to say equal if, look through all of these values in column B, and if they're greater than 100, then give me the row number of that cell. Otherwise, give me some large number. So I'm going to use 999 here because we only have 20 rows. If you had 100,000 rows, you'd use 999999. And what that's going to do is that's going to return for us anytime that the number is greater than 100, it's going to return the row number. So row number 9, row number 13, row number 14, row number 15, and so on. And then a whole bunch of 999s for all the small things. So from there, I want to know the min. Give me the min of all those numbers. And we will press enter. Control shift enter. And it says that we are in row 9. So sure enough, the first one that's greater than 100 is in row 9. If we would put in something here that was greater than 100, that automatically changes to show us which value, which row contains the first value greater than 100. From there then, we will ask for the index of column A. Which item do we want? We want the answer from the min. Control shift to enter the whole thing. 165. A little test here. We'll make this be 92. So now we should be going down to the 189 and returning the 117. Now, as I said in the title, it wouldn't be nice if we could do a VLOOKUP and specify we're looking for the first thing greater than 100. Or in this case, it would actually be a match. But that doesn't work. And if you try and do the VLOOKUP, the true version of VLOOKUP, or the comma 1 version of match, it doesn't necessarily return the first one. It returns one of them that is greater than 100, but not the first one. So lots of failed attempts on my part. Mike, I'm interested to see what elegant, beautiful formula you have to solve this.
Thanks, Mr. Excel. Elegant, beautiful. I love this. That is beautiful and elegant. Now, I'm going to use a slightly different formula. I'm still going to use the index to look up through that A column. All right, let's come over here. All right, so the first thing, if our hurdle is 100, I'm going to go ahead and build a formula that asks the question, hey, are any of you values here, and that's a bunch of values, are you greater than our hurdle? Now, that's an operator acting on an array of items. So when I highlight this and hit the F9 key, it's an array operation, which returns an array of values. Notice trues and falses. And what are we interested in? We're interested in the first true. Now, notice there's lots of duplicates here. Control Z. We want the first true. No problem. I can put that inside the match function. Now, what am I looking up? The first true. So the lookup value will be true, comma. That lookup array right there is an array operation. That match function cannot calculate this correctly or deliver the right answer to the cell unless we enter it with Control Shift Enter. That argument only will calculate correctly if we use Control Shift Enter. Now, here's the trick for match, because we're interested in the first. If we say exact match, that means it will, if there are duplicates, only get the first one, which is the position 1, 2, 3. The match will deliver the relative position. So if I hit enter, not going to work. I have to use Control Shift and enter. There it is, the third position. Notice the curly brackets up here. We do Control Shift Enter to tell Excel this is an array formula. Those curly brackets are Excel saying, hey, I understood you wanted an array calculation. Now I'm simply going to put that relative position into index. The array, those are the values we want to look up, comma. Row number, we know that's going to be 3. That will be perfect. Close parentheses. Enter gives me an error because I have to use Control Shift and enter. Notice the curly brackets up there. That means Excel understood. Now, if you wanted to not have to remember to do Control Shift Enter, we'll look at something silly here. I'm going to copy this because that's a beautiful formula right there. You don't use Control Shift Enter. But watch this. We can take this lookup array that is sitting in the lookup array argument inside of match. Now, right now it's an array operation, so when match gets it, it says, I need Control Shift Enter. But watch this. We can convert it to, in essence, a range by putting it inside of index. That argument can understand calculating array operations without Control Shift Enter. But watch this. What do we want? We want to deliver the whole column of values to match. So I'm going to come to the end here and comma for row number. If I leave it empty or put a 0, and I'm going to leave it empty, that tells index, give me all the row numbers, which will mean all the trues and falses. So what we're doing here is we're tricking. That argument can handle array operations without Control Shift Enter. Index spits out a range of values that then lookup array and match can understand without Control Shift Enter. So watch, enter.
165.
All right, throw it back to Mr. Excel.
Hey, all right, Mike, that is one cool formula there, using the index with a blank row in order to avoid having to do Control Shift Enter. I love it. All right, well, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. We'll see you next week for another Dueling Excel podcast from Mr. Excel, and Excel is fun.